Ohio Senator Rob Portman joins me right now. Senator, you're not a fan of the president doing this from the White House or the Treasury issuing rules. This is your job, Congress's job, right? Because the president just said, well, you're not doing, not you specifically, you're not doing your job, so I'm going to have to do it for you. What do you say?
Well, look, the problem is it won't help. I mean, you talked about the pharmaceutical industry. Let's take the example of AbbVie, who, as you know, wanted to invert, and Shire was their intended target. So they were going to combine the two companies. Because of the regulations that were put up by the administration last time, they decided to call it off because of the 80-20 rule on the shareholders. What's happened since then? As you know, Neil, Shire has come to the United States and now bought four major pharmaceutical companies in the last 14 months. The last one was a $32 billion acquisition. So it doesn't solve the problem. The problem is not just the fact that there are inversions going on, which none of us like. The problem is we got a tax code that makes no sense. It's driving investment and jobs overseas. So you've got to get the rate down. Stephen Moore talked about the fact that the president's proposal actually increases taxes on the U.S. worker, which is really what this is about. This is about the worker. This is not about the companies. These people in the boardrooms will be fine. It's about the workers who end up getting the short end of the stick. We've got to reform the tax code. And for the president to put out higher taxes makes no sense.
You've made efforts again and again in a variety of positions to do just that. It never seems to happen. But what seems to be more problematic for your party, Senator, on this, the big Wisconsin primary day, I know your backer, John Kasich, is that the front runner, Donald Trump, largely mirrors the position of the president on this matter. He doesn't like inversions. He doesn't like companies going to other locales to take advantage of lower rates. He doesn't much flip over Ford, investing $1.5 billion in Mexico to build small cars. Says he'll slap a tax on those vehicles when they're shipped here. So is he out of sync with your party? Is the party out of sync with him? What?
You know, he talks about a lot of stuff, but one thing he has talked about, to his credit, is the fact that the tax code is a mess. It's broken. It has to be fixed. And specifically, he talks about the fact, as you know, that there's over $2 trillion. He says $2.5 trillion locked up overseas. That could come back if you did something along the lines of what Steve Moore talked about, which is to allow companies to bring that money back at a much lower rate.
That's part of tax reform. Senator, can the president do what he's doing by executive fiat? I mean, there have been a lot of executive orders.
Oh, yeah, he can. But it's not going to help.
All of these deals freeze in the meantime until a new president or Congress. If it's Hillary Clinton or Bernie Sanders, I can't imagine that will change much. So the message to U.S. companies could be, you know, foreigners may come here, but you can't go there.
Neil, some of these regulatory changes they're proposing will make a difference. These are rules changes. Some of them won't. These are small ball things. This is, you know, how you calculate the 80% U.S. shareholder rule as to the 20% that's foreign. You don't include those companies that they have bought in America in the 20%. So these are really pretty small things.
Yeah,
and I don't know how it'll affect individual transactions.
I agree. They're very small.
We've got to get at the underlying problem.
They will make a difference on a $150 billion deal going through. And because of those small ball changes, they are going to be so prohibitive that I wouldn't be surprised if later today Pfizer announces the deal is off.
I don't know. I can't tell you because I don't know the specifics of that deal, but I will tell you that the last regulations they put out didn't stop Pfizer from going ahead with the announcement of a deal with Allergan. So it didn't work last time, and it depends. I mean, there's an earnings stripping provision to it as well. That may hurt what they're trying to do. But the point is, Neil, all of this makes U.S. companies even more of a target to be taken over by a foreign company. Think about it. This makes a U.S. company even more attractive now to a foreign entity. And we're losing companies right and left, not just by inversions, but by foreign companies coming, like Shire has done with these four pharmaceutical companies, buying U.S. companies. Try to buy an American beer these days. You know, Sam Adams is the largest brewery with 1.4% market share. They've all been taken over by foreign companies. That's a problem, and I am going to continue to fight on. And by the way, the Republican leadership ought to be behind this. The Democratic leadership ought to be behind this. The president ought to be behind it. Let's not make it, you know, a tax increase.
Yeah, but
let's
then
keep it at least
get
revenue neutral
behind it, because he is not reading from the same choir book when it comes to these.
Well, I don't know that. I think on this specific part of the tax code, I think he would agree that it's crazy for us to have a situation where we're locking up all that money overseas. Instead, let's bring it back here and invest it.
But he's against corporate inversions, and he's against Ford building cars in Mexico. So.
Well, this is how you fix that corporate inversion issue, is you actually fix the tax code. And I think actually what you said on this in terms of the tax reform side makes sense in terms of bringing that money back to America,
Senator,
investing it here.
Thank you very, very much for taking the time on this busy news day.
Neil, always great to be with you, my friend.
All
Take care.
Senator Rob Portman.